One of President Trump's favorite targets, Lisa Page, is defending herself after 2 years of silence. That defense coming in a new interview with the Daily Beast. Page, in a single tweet on a new account, tweeted this: "I'm done being quiet." President Trump has regularly criticized and ridiculed the former FBI lawyer, along with former FBI agent Peter Strzok, after text messages between the two were made public about 2 years ago. Page says she chose to come forward now because of this at a recent Trump rally.
"I love you, Peter. I love you too, Lisa. Lisa, I love you. Lisa. Lisa. Oh, God, I love you, Lisa. And if she doesn't win, Lisa, we've got an insurance policy, Lisa."
Trying to process that. We'll come back. This is one of the things she said to the Daily Beast: "The President of the United States is calling me names to the entire world. It's sickening, but it's also very intimidating because he's still the President of the United States. And when the President accuses you of treason by name, despite the fact that I know there's no fathomable way that I have committed any crime at all, let alone treason, he's still somebody in a position to actually do something about that." It is interesting for her, A, to come forward, because mm-hmm. now you're risking provoking him to do more by coming forward. And B, obviously the timing here, we're expecting the Department of Justice Inspector General report out next week. One of the questions for the Inspector General was to address the texting between Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, certainly improper, but was there anything wrong done?
Well, so this piece by Molly John Fast for the Daily Beast, it really goes through the beginning of this to the end of this for Lisa Page. And to what you referenced, she doesn't think she does anything wrong. She thinks that the IG report that's supposed to come out on December 9th is going to exonerate her. But she also says it doesn't really matter, that the president has this megaphone and will continue to make her life difficult, no matter whether or not this report says that she did anything wrong. But she also says she's a lawyer. She knows what the boundaries were when she was texting, and she says that I of anyone would understand that I didn't do anything. I still don't think I did anything wrong here.
Right. She says she had a personal opinion that she shared with a man with whom she was having a relationship in their text messages. But she says she was able to put her blinders back on and do her job as a professional when it came to what should we do about the information before us in the Russia investigation. To the point about the IG report, she said, "While it would be nice to have the IG confirm publicly that my personal opinions had absolutely no bearing on the course of the Russia investigations, I don't kid myself that the facts will matter very much. Fact will not matter very much for a lot of people. The president has a very loud megaphone." Mm-hmm. And this is an interesting, beyond Lisa Page. A lot of the reporting so far, based on sources about what the IG is going to say, is yes, some judgment calls, yes, one low-level lawyer who altered a document, and that's reprehensible. However, Carter Page warrant was warranted. There was no political bias in the FBI leadership in the investigation. That's not what the president wants to hear.
I think it's the alternative facts, as the president's own White House has said, that he likes to push, that his base believes more so than, you know, this report might say or what Lisa Page might say. And I think that's why it's interesting that she has chosen to speak out at this time, even though she knows that no matter what she says, there will be a significant portion of the American population who will never believe her.
Also, you know, it's also a reminder that on both sides of the aisle, people who are used as pinatas are human beings.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Right. And the fact that she came out as a human being and as somebody who talks very, very specifically about what it's like to walk down the street and see somebody wearing a MAGA hat and wondering if they recognize her and she needs to look the other way is a reminder that we, as partisan and as tribal and as horrible as the times are, these are human beings.
We'll watch as this one plays out as well. It's an interesting decision to come forward. Up next for us, a little bit of a lightning round. But before we go to break, 2020 candidate Senator Michael Bennet evokes the Hillary Clinton campaign. Here you go. Not doing it.
"I'm just chilling in Cedar Rapids, listening to Ave Maria.
I'm just chilling in Cedar Rapids.